Hi, I'm Ted Bollinger with TVS Pro, and in this video we're going to be comparing multiple 4K and 4KE enhanced projectors. The reason for this is the introduction of the new Optoma UHD65, which is an under $2,500 true 4K projector. And the question we all have is, how does it hold up against some of these higher end projectors, at least higher end in terms of their cost? So we'll be taking a look at it next to our reference standard in the under $10,000 home theater projector market, which is the Sony VPL-VW365ES. The Sony has amazing blacks, and because of its reflective chips using red, green, blue, it also has extremely good color and great detail. We'll also be comparing it to the Epson 4040, which is a 3LCD transmissive, meaning the light's going through the chips, which is generally harder to get good contrast. I think you'll be surprised how it does. We'll also be looking at the Epson, their flagship projector in the home theater market, which is the 10,500. This uses laser and it uses three chips, but they're reflective chips. So we'll see how these compare. We'll be using this Studio Tech 130 reference screen from Stewart. This is 235:1, so we're able to put two 16:9 images side by side. We'll be zooming in on those, so hopefully you'll be able to see when we come to the detail. As far as color and contrast, you really won't need to zoom in as much for those. So we look forward to seeing how these compare, and I hope you do too. So here you can see kind of how we're set up. We've got two cameras set up to record this. We've taken, you can see the wires hanging down. We've taken the VPL-VW365, which we use as our reference under $10,000 home theater projector. We've taken it off and it's side by side. You can see it on the right, it's on the left, and the little Optoma is over on the right. So that's kind of how we're set up, and now we're gonna kill the lights and zoom in so you can see what we're doing. Because this can't go, well, realistically is not going to go higher than HD with good quality on the internet, we'll also do some close-ups on the screen so you can see when we get to the detail part. So before we do any projector comparison, especially when a side-by-side, you want to make sure, if you do nothing else, make sure that the contrast and brightness are set. If those are not set properly, then you're really wasting your time because you're not really comparing what the projectors can do. So what you're looking at here is on the right is the Optoma, on the left the Optoma UHD65, and on the left is the Sony 365ES, VPL-VW365ES. Now what you're looking at is a combination Pluge pattern and a contrast or peak white setting. In this exposure right here, you can begin to see the Pluge or the vertical bars on both sides of the white chips. Now the white chips should be 6500 degrees. They're both set to what the manufacturer has said is their default setting. The Sony is very close to being on. We are not going to do a professional calibration. We wanted to compare these as they are out of the box if you put them in their best settings. So the Optoma is close, but it's a little bit out. To the eye, it actually appears closer than what I'm seeing on the viewfinder. But the thing here that we're setting is we're not adjusting color, we're adjusting contrast and brightness. Those two are very critical to get the full capability out of your display, any display. So I'm going to change the exposure here so that you can see all of the little white bars, the black bars on the left and the right. They gradually get darker. And when you're setting Pluge, and it's already been set on these projectors, but I'm adjusting the exposure on the camera to about where you'd have it, you want to just be able to see just a hint of the last bar, which is at 5 IRE. And once you've adjusted brightness, you may have to go back. Brightness is actually adjusting the dark parts of the picture, which is sometimes confusing. But the brightness, you're adjusting the darks, and the contrast, you're affecting the whites. So I'm going to zoom in here to the Optoma so you can see that top chip. And on that top chip, you'll see that you're not seeing another chip inside it. So I'm going to bring the exposure down a little bit, and as I bring the exposure down, okay, see the chip? So that's how you know you're not losing some of the fine details. If you've got your contrast too high, that little chip will disappear. And if you've got it just right, you want it just as you can begin to see and make sure you've got that. So we'll go over here to the Sony and you'll see that we can see the Sony chip and we can see the Optoma chip. So they're both set to their optimum contrast, and we want to do that before we do our other comparisons. This image is a little funner to look at than color bars, and is a graphic on the Extron shootout disk developed for Infocom several years ago. But if you compare the colors here, it's very hard to really see any significant differences. The yellows look great here, the greens, the blues, white is excellent on both of them and really pops. So this gives you an idea of how close these projectors are in terms of their color. Now that we've set our Pluge pattern by getting the very best blacks without crushing and using the contrast, the white square on the white, we're able to get the very most detail in the highlights. So now here is an image that has extreme contrast from the deep black of space to the bright light on the shuttle, and then of course the Earth in the background. So what I've done here is I've reversed the image so that you can see the same part of the picture side by side. Again, we're not really looking for detail in this image so much as we're looking at how much difference in contrast is there. And it's hard to see in this recording, but with the eye, the Sony blacks are just one step a little bit darker and blacker, more velvety. The Optoma, there is some light energy there. I can open up this iris, it'll overexpose the picture, but you may be able to see some of the differences in the black there. But again, this is, if you're on a budget and under $5,000, this is not a bad trade-off at all. The Sony is definitely a little bit better, but it should be. It's a more expensive projector. I think it's currently at $79.95. But this is showing you how good the contrast is on an extreme contrast slide where you've got nice bright highlights and you've got the deep black of space, and then also the top part of that satellite looks like they're launching. This slide, before we move on to actually looking at 4K detail, is a great example of combining color, contrast, intensity. It's important to note that the Sony is in the low lamp mode so that we can balance these two. The Optoma is in its high bright. So there is a difference in brightness between these projectors. If you're going to do a large screen, the Sony is clearly the choice if you have the budget. But this slide is interesting because it allows you to see how close the colors are, how close the detail is. This is not 4K detail at this point. We're going to do that in a few minutes. This is, these test patterns are at 1080p, so you're actually seeing 1080p. And I'm not sure how much of this will show up on the actual video, but they're very close, but there is a difference in the veining in that light purple leaf. So if you look at the Sony on the left, depending on how this comes across on the internet, you may or may not be able to see it. We'll do a still photo of this too, so that we can post that in our on our website so you can take a close look at it. But there is a slight difference. It could be the digital reality creation, which is a 10-year database on a chip that Sony uses to apply textures, surfaces, and detail without over-enhancing the image. But there's clearly a difference there in the detail, in the leaves. It's particularly noticeable in the veining on that purple leaf. But again, both those images, I'd be happy with either one of those. Very, very exciting projector. The Optoma is doing a great job, and considering its price range, it's amazing. This will be a little more helpful for a comparison because now you're seeing the exact same image. We've taken the Optoma and flipped the image left to right using its remote and its capability of doing rear projection. So now you are looking at the same information. We're going to zoom in a little of this a little bit more to hopefully be able to reveal some of the details. And hopefully it looks like this is going to come out much better, because now on the left, again, we have the Sony, on the right we have the Optoma, and it's absolutely amazing how well this Optoma is doing. As we mentioned, as we went through the other parts of color and contrast, obviously the Sony, as it should in its price range, is significantly better in contrast. Its blacks are absolutely silky black. And in terms of color, they are close, but the Sony has an advantage in terms of saturation and in terms of accuracy because of its red, green, blue, but that's very, very minimal. It's mainly the contrast that you will see in the image that's the big difference. The other difference, of course, is the Sony is in its low mode, low lamp mode, and the Optoma, when you're in reference, goes and we're in its brightest mode. So the Sony in its low mode is about the same brightness and measures within 1 or 2 foot candles of what the Optoma is doing. So the Sony does have the capability of not only better blacks and contrast, but it does have the higher brightness. But if you're on a budget of under $5,000, then absolutely the Optoma is the best projector we have seen out there in the under $5,000 range, as you can see in these detailed images. Okay, what we're going to look at now is a comparison again of the Sony on the left, the Optoma UHD65 on the right, and this time we're using the Oppo. This is a 4K Blu-ray that's playing. And we're going to zoom in a little bit. We've reversed the image on the right so that what you see will be exactly the same. And by zooming in on here, now this, the difference between what we're watching before, that was off a Sony server specifically for the 365, and that was 4K60, which is the frame rate and the data rate that kind of challenges the best of projectors. This is the more common type of image that you'll be seeing, which is 24 frames per second, not 60, and it's coming off a 4K disc. So what you are looking at here is in reality a side-by-side of the two images. And hopefully by being zoomed in this close, you'll be able to get an idea of how close these projectors are. And again, the Optoma is absolutely amazing, the best under $5,000 home theater projector we have seen. It has an excellent balance of color, brightness, extreme detail because it is true 4K and has great focus. Very, very good alignment of the optics in the lens inside. It is razor sharp. The Sony, on the other hand, is a step up because you are picking up a higher level of contrast. And as we mentioned before, you're in the low range right now, comparing it to the bright range of the Optoma. So if you're doing a large screen, you're going to want the Sony if you've got the budget. If not, you can put the Optoma in some of the other modes and trade off a little bit of color for brightness. But in this mode, which again is in the reference mode, it has extremely good color, contrast, and detail.